Ladies and gentlemen, may we all rise in honor of the bride? This is a very special occasion in joining Natalie and Aaron in the union of marriage. And who gives this bride to be?
Mother.
Aaron, may you receive the bride and bring her forward. Thank you, and you may be seated. I'm Natalie and Aaron. The two of you have had separate paths that led you to this very moment. And that's what the sand ceremony later on will also represent. Your two lives, as well as a family, will becoming one through marriage. And if there's a few things that I hope would carry along its way throughout your journey in marriage, it would be that from the heart, that the two of you would have the ability to listen, learn, and to love. Listen to one another, what it is that they have to offer, and what makes them feel whole and part of this relationship. Because after all, they just may be the voice of reason. And secondly, the ability to learn. Learn what it takes to help the other fulfill every desire, every wish, every dream, and every goal that they may have. And lastly, the ability to love. To love unconditionally, which means no strings attached. This is an ongoing love. And this is the type of love that I hope the two of you would wish to express to one another each and every day. Aaron, keeping in mind that Natalie's happiness will be more important than your own. And also, Natalie, that Aaron's happiness will be far more important than yours. And with that in your minds and in your hearts, I'm sure your lives together will be everything that you want it to be. So Aaron, I'll ask you first. Your presence here today, alongside Natalie, do you take her as your wife in promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting her always, allowing nothing or no one to come between the two of you? Do you take her as your wife? And Natalie, I'll ask you the same. With your presence here today, alongside Aaron, do you take him to be your husband in promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting him always, allowing nothing or no one to come between the two of you? Do you take him as your husband?
I do.
Okay. At this time, if I could have you hand over your bouquet. And if you guys could turn and face each other and hold each other's hands. Now, looking into each other's eyes, you will see the very reason why you are here today, proving that at this moment, there is no one more important than who stands before you. So, Aaron, looking into her eyes, I'll have you go first in repeating your vows. I, Aaron, take you, Natalie.
I, Aaron, take you, Natalie.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I will be there for you.
I will be there for you.
Through good times and bad times.
Through good times and bad times.
Whether we are rich or poor.
Whether we are rich or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Through laughter and tears.
Through laughter and tears.
I will love and cherish you.
I will love and cherish you.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
Thank you, sir. Now, Natalie, looking into his eyes, if you could please repeat your vows. I, Natalie, take you, Aaron.
I, Natalie, take you, Aaron.
To be my husband. I will stand beside you.
I will stand beside you.
Through success or misfortune.
Through success or misfortune.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Through laughter and tears.
Through laughter and tears.
I will love and cherish you.
I will love and cherish you.
I give you my pledge. Thank you. And at this time, may I have the rings, please? Now, these rings are not only tokens, but symbols of the love and devotion that the two of you are expressing here today. And my hope is that as you wear these rings, may it remind you each and every day of exactly that promise and pledge. And in time, these rings may lose beauty, but I hope that you value and take honor in wearing these rings for what they truly represent. And through your friends and family, the beauty will shine through you both. And the two of you will be a wonderful example to all. Sarah, Lassie, you slipped that on her ring finger. And if you could please repeat, with this ring.
With this ring.
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
Be your faithful and loving husband.
And I feel so honored.
And I feel so honored.
To call you my wife.
To call you my wife.
Thank you. Nevin, you can slip that upon his ring finger. And if you could please repeat, with this ring.
With this ring.
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
And I feel so honored.
And I feel so honored.
To call you my husband. At this time, if I could have you step over to the sand ceremony. Now, Natalie and Aaron, you come here today to join your lives together. From these two people, a new family will be created today. We recognize the significant role of Joey here, that he plays in this marriage that is celebrated today. Representing each cylinder, who each and every one of you are. You are joined together today, not only in marriage, but as family. If I could have each and every one of you take a hold of your individual cylinders. And just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, so will become the bond with your family. Not only your individual lives, but that also of your families as well. I'll invite you back to the front of the podium. Okay. Now, Natalie and Aaron, if you love somebody, you'll be loyal to them no matter what the cost. You will always stand beside them. You will always trust them. And you will stand your ground in defending them, no matter what. Now, there's a saying that I like to leave with the two of you. And it says, don't walk in front of me, I may not follow. Don't walk behind me, I may not lead. But walk beside me as a friend. Because after all, throughout your journey in marriage, that's what the two of you will be building upon, is a deeper, richer, stronger friendship built upon the foundation, your wonderful relationship that you already have. And I would also hope that the two of you would not only love each other for who they are, but for what they are helping to make of you. So the 6th of October, a day that will now mark your anniversary, in the presence of friends and family as witnesses, The two of you have showed your intention by the exchanging of your vows and the exchanging of your rings. Therefore, with the power vested in me by the state of Nevada, it is my honor and privilege to now be able to pronounce you as husband and wife. Aaron, you may now kiss your wife, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Ayers, the newlyweds.